Hello.
I'm Jean. Greedy from Gartner. Jean, nice to meet you. How are you?
Doing good. How you doing?
I'm doing well. Thanks for meeting with me on such short notice.
Sure.
You know, I have to give you a compliment right off the bat. I have absolutely loved working with Bob. He's such a great addition to your team.
Yeah, he's actually leaving the company, unfortunately.
Oh, no way.
He just resigned. He's retiring.
Oh, my gosh. He never mentioned that to me. Did he mention... Oh, just retiring because of age?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or just he just wants to do something else.
Gotcha. No. So are you replacing that CEO position?
No, I'm actually going to be taking over for him for foreseeable future for some of his responsibilities.
So how do you feel about that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a big job he had, so it's good timing that you reached out, because I'm intrigued with this additional responsibility. There's some questions that I have.
Definitely. Well, he had a great vision for the future, so I'm excited to see what you can bring to the table, and it's good to see that you're so eager to take on this role.
Yeah.
Great. Well, I know he mentioned that you have some background with Gartner, but I just wanted to catch you up to speed on my position. So I'm a Gartner sales executive, and I love my job because I get to come to work and every single day and work with CIOs just like you to help them make strategic decisions, save them time, money, and mitigating risk. So I'd love to take this time today to recap on that meeting with Bob and the goals and concerns he addressed to me. I would love to hear your side of the story and see what else you have, any goals you have, especially because you're taking on this new position. And then finally, I'd love to help you see how you could leverage Gartner as a value partner in accomplishing your goals. So is there anything else you'd like to speak about today?
No, that sounds good.
Okay, good. And then I wanted to give you my business card, just in case you have any additional questions, feel free to reach out. Okay. And do you have a copy of yours as well?
I don't have one with me, unfortunately.
I'll hit you up on LinkedIn.
All right, sounds good.
And is 20 minutes still all right for this meeting?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, fantastic. So Bob mentioned that you'd be the main decision maker for this, for forming a partnership with Gartner. Is that still correct?
Yep.
Okay, is there anyone else that's going to have a seat at the table in that decision?
I mean, kind of budget's a big issue, so we're reducing our costs. So
that's budget,
the,
okay.
That's the big limitation at the moment.
Any other main criteria on forming a partnership with Gartner?
No, nothing I can think of.
Okay, well, I'll be glad to address budget with you today. And then finally, what's your timeline look like for forming this partnership?
For Gartner partnership?
Yes.
I don't have one. I'm just curious to see what you guys are all about.
Gotcha. Well, that's why I'm here. I'd love to show you. So Bob mentioned a lot of needs to me in our meeting. His main priority was that new EMR system.
Mm-hmm.
In addition, he wanted to improve internal customer satisfaction scores. And then finally, he wanted to examine your current IT budget. It sounded like there were some discrepancies there on how you wanted to proceed with that. So do those goals sound relevant to you?
I mean, high level, I think just the biggest thing is reducing our costs. So the budget is, that's what I'm being asked to do.
Okay.
Just reduce costs.
Okay, so is that your main concern at this point?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and are there any additional concerns or goals you have, especially because you are taking on this new role, you'd like to address?
I mean, with Bob's area of expertise with the medical record systems, mm-hmm. That's something I'm investigating to more so to identify some of the problems that might be apparent that could expose us to some risk, lawsuits, some bad things,
if they're not
appropriately addressed. So I want to make sure that those are running appropriately.
So am I correct in assuming that you're more interested in fixing the current EMR system than getting a new one? Or are you still interested in finding a new system?
I just want a system that doesn't expose us to risk, whether it's the current one or a new one. I don't really care.
Gets the job done.
Yep.
Okay, for sure. So I'd love to go through each of those goals and kind of dive deeper into what we're looking at there. So if you want to start with that IT budget, Bob mentioned to me that currently your IT budget is 1.5% of your total revenue.
Mm-hmm.
Is that statistic correct still?
Yeah, I mean, it sounds about right.
Okay.
Yeah.
And he was really looking to improve that budget, but then he mentioned there was some pushback with the CEO wanting to cut costs.
Mm-hmm.
How do you feel about the IT budget?
I mean, we're being asked to cut costs again, mm-hmm. so it's been a long-standing thing where we're looking to run leaner and leaner.
Mm-hmm.
It's what our CEO is tasking us to do. I mean, I've got a general gut feel that it's getting a little bit too tight for us to be able to operate the way that we need to.
Mm-hmm.
So I've got to do it because my boss is telling me to do it.
For sure.
But I've got strong opinions on the why behind it.
Okay.
And the biggest thing is, if we're there's some additional investments that I want to make that I'm not able to make that I think,
gotcha.
I think could put us in hot water if we don't really take mm-hmm. them seriously.
So it sounds like you would rather grow the budget, but you're getting that pressure upwards to shrink that budget?
Yeah, I mean, I know mm-hmm. we need to, I'm just struggling with like where to, how to approach it.
Definitely.
It just seems like it's a little bit, that's a little bit too low.
For
or
sure.
Or too under-resourced.
Okay, so have you done any budget analysis to examine how efficient you're being with the money you're spending?
Not really.
Okay. And do you think that would be something that would be beneficial to making this decision?
Yeah, it would be interesting.
Okay. And when is your budget up for review?
Well, it's just reviewed, so we're looking to get the cost cutting done throughout this year. So
those are changes that could be made immediately?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, great. And then finally, what do you think would be the impact of cutting these costs on the efficiency of your IT department?
I mean, it improves our operating, how we're operating. We don't want to, I mean, we're non-for-profit, but we don't want to be over invested in certain things.
For sure.
So we want to run efficiently, I think is the biggest thing. But the biggest impact I'm looking at is like how much is too much, right? Where
totally.
If we expose ourselves to some undue risk if we're not compliant with some of the laws and regulations out there. I mean, it takes investments to be able to do that.
Definitely.
And with the increased needs and increased amount of data we're collecting, like we've got to mm-hmm. be able to do that effectively.
Yeah. It's a fine line you walk between mm-hmm. not spending enough money and, you know, wasting those dollars. Great. So I wanted to address that new EMR system as well with you. He was pretty set on finding a new one. It sounds like you're in agreement with that. Why do you think that's necessary?
Well, I'm not necessarily in agreement with it. It's just I want the EMR system to work and not expose us to undue risk.
You know, gotcha.
We've got all the regulations that we have to be compliant with.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't think Bob was more focused on like user friendliness and making the doctors happy, where I'm more focused on like doing the hard things right, which is, you know, being compliant with all the laws and regulations and
gotcha.
You know, making sure we're being safe from any lawsuits that mm-hmm. happen, right?
Uh-huh. And just to make sure I'm following, so you're mm-hmm. talking about like confidentiality of the patients who come to your hospital?
Yeah, confidentiality and just the following the process and mm-hmm. how we're collecting information and getting, you know, their consent signed and that categorized efficiently, communicating it with the appropriate organizations that are out there.
Mm-hmm.
Just, you know, if something happens in the hospital and unfortunately somebody like dies as a result,
yes.
and they find out that we didn't follow the process, that's a really bad situation for us to be in.
Gotcha. So is this an issue that you've been having currently or something that you're worried about having in the future?
Well, it's a little bit of both. It's like because if we have risk in our systems currently,
uh-huh.
it's just a time bomb for something to happen.
Okay.
And then once something happens, that's where the investigations start. They start to find things. You have to have a reason to look.
Yeah.
Right now, thankfully, they don't. But I don't want that. We're going to be in that situation at some point.
Definitely.
We'll get audited and lawsuits will happen. We just have to make sure we're ironclad protected
yeah.
behind it. I don't care about anything else Bob was working on, but like making the systems more, you know, like doctor friendly. I mean, that was his thing. And I think that's why I'm kind of taking over to make sure that we're doing it the right way.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, you want to make sure all your bases are covered. And there is that huge risk that it hasn't happened yet, but when it does happen, I mean, it's really going to be a big impact on your company.
Mm-hmm.
So I see where you're coming from there. Where are you at in that process, though? Have you done any research into how to make your current system better at these legalities, working on the process of your doctors?
I mean, it's a catch-22 because I'm being mm-hmm. told to reduce costs. So anything we
gotcha.
Do is going to increase our costs, and it's something I think about, but I don't have a plan in place.
Okay.
I mean, I'm going to conferences and I hear things and best practices where I mm-hmm. kind of get the sense that we're missing the mark with things.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I don't have too much planned for that other than the conferences that I'm signed up for.
Okay. And do you have a hard time finding information on how to achieve this goal and solve all those legality problems? Because, you know, you can talk to people mm-hmm. as much as you want, but it's hard to find that hardcore evidence sometimes.
Yeah. I mean, the conferences have been helpful. I'm going to a Gartner conference, actually, tomorrow.
Oh, no way.
Yeah.
Okay, wait, which location?
It's San Francisco. It's a healthcare conference.
Yeah, I won't be there, but I would love to connect you with some of my friends that are going to be there.
Yeah, totally.
That'd be great. So when do you need to have this done by? Is sort of as far as sorting out the legalities?
Legalities is, I don't have a plan for it. The budget needs to be done in place by the end of 2018, so I need to have everything cut.
Gotcha.
And off the books by then.
Okay, wow.
Yeah.
And, I mean, you're going to have to adjust a lot with those budget cuts, so you probably want to work on that sooner rather than later.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And then finally, what would be the magnitude of not working out all these budget costs and all these issues you're having? How would that impact your ability to succeed as a hospital?
My CEO would be upset.
That's a big one.
Yeah. I think he just wants to run the ship the way that he wants to run it, so... Mm-hmm.
Especially taking on these new roles, you don't want him upset with you,
yeah.
Do you?
The thing is, we can cut our costs. It's just a matter of, like, what's going to be lost as a result.
For sure. You know? Well, I think we've had a great discussion today. I've gained a lot of information on you, and I think there's definitely a way that Gartner could help you with that. If we could help you solve those IT budgets without cutting the efficiencies of your department, would you be interested in learning more?
Depends on pricing and everything.
For sure. Okay. We'll make sure to get back to that. But I wanted to start off by showing you this IT budget comparison summary.
Okay.
And this is something that I think you'll be really interested to see because it's actually relevant to the healthcare industry.
Mm-hmm.
So right now you told me that the IT budget is 1.5%,
mm-hmm.
but the industry average is actually 4.3% of revenue.
Mm-hmm.
I think there's definitely some leverage there where you can look at how you're spending your money and see if there's a more efficient way of the breakdown of how much money you're spending on staffing, how much money you're spending on software.
Yeah, so that's the industry. So that's the peers in the industry. That's what they're investing. Is that right?
Definitely, yeah. So this gives you a lot of market visibility to see how other people are spending their money and how, when you're faced with a tight budget, you can maybe allocate those costs to a better spend. So does this sound like something that would be helpful to you?
The 4.3 is interesting because it's way, way above what we're currently have in house. So I wasn't, I mean, I had a gut feel that we were a little bit underinvested, but that's a big, big difference.
For sure. And I mean, that's even leverage for you if you go to a meeting and you have these great ideas for IT and things that could really move your hospital forward,
mm-hmm.
and they're saying there's not dollars in the budget, you could say, well, our competitors are doing this. Like, if we're going to keep up with them, we got to meet those industry averages.
Mm-hmm.
So does this look like something that you could use in those meetings?
I could use it my CEO to get more budget potentially.
Definitely. And do you think that would help at all with the cost issues you're having?
I think having some hard evidence would be, I need some ammunition if I'm going to ask for something. This is good.
Definitely. So I wanted to move on to that ERM system as well with you. We do have a lot of research that will help you with that decision and help you improve the process for how you're addressing that. So I wanted to draw your attention to our Gartner web portal.
Mm-hmm.
And in here, we have all the documents. We have 135,000 documents that'll help you with that decision. So I just went ahead and searched the EMRS system, and I found over 1,000 documents that are best practices and case studies with EMRS systems. So we could even look at the current system you do have, look at best practices and case studies for how to improve the efficiencies of how you're using that and cover all your bases as far as legalities.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you wanted to look into a new system, there'd be research on that as well and how you could implement that. So does that look like something that would be beneficial to you?
Yeah, it's a good bit of information you have.
How do you think it would help your company?
I mean, if you had anything on like this, like using it to make sure you're compliant. Because I'm less concerned with the vendor. It's more about just the best practices of how we can make sure that we're covering all our bases, like you said.
Gotcha. So that is something that would be covered in here. You could look at your specific vendor that you have right now and look into how people are executing that in their hospitals, how they're communicating to their doctors of how to use the system and making sure everything gets done. So that would definitely be covered in this research.
Okay.
So I know we've talked about a lot today. Do you think this is something that could benefit your company?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. And you did mention that cost is going to be really important to you. Was that in relation to the cost of our product or in your cost savings?
I mean, it's just our budget as it stands right now.
For sure.
I don't have any wiggle room in it.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd have to, I mean, I like the tool that can be good for building a case.
Definitely. A lot of people really appreciate the use of that tool.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm glad this is something that you see benefit in your company. Here's what the pricing breakdown looks like for Gartner for CIOs, which
mm-hmm.
is the product you'd be signing on to. So it's $50,000 for the license for the CIO, and then for each of the direct reports, it's $15,000 in the first year.
Yeah.
So does that look like something that'd be feasible for your company?
Um, Yeah, I'm just trying to think about where I'm going to pull that money from.
Definitely. And with these cost savings you might be able to have in the IT department, mm-hmm. it is possible that you would still be able to cut your total IT spend, but just by redistributing how you're spending that money in your department, you would be able to get a lot of cost savings from that.
Yeah, I can see how it could be helpful. Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people do like to consider this as more of an investment than an upfront spend. So especially taking on this new role, you're trying to grow the IT department with some constrained budget. So by investing this money upfront and having access to all of our tools, I mean, there are even things in this research that don't address the CRM or the EMRS systems. Mm-hmm. So things that you could look forward to improving the IT department in different strategies. So do you think this cost would be something feasible for your company?
I gotta work on budget and everything, but that's the biggest limitation is, I can technically buy it, but it's just not in the budget right now.
Definitely. So we are going to be with you every single step of the way. And as well, we also have an executive partner. And this is someone that I think would really help you with forming that budget. Mm-hmm. So you can have a 1 hour monthly phone call with this person. And I mean, this is something you could even do next week with them if you decide to sign today and say, look, here are our numbers. Here's the cost we need to cut. Help us get there. And they have 10 years or more experience in the industry, and they will be able to create that roadmap with you of how to do that.
Yeah, I've heard of those executive partners. How do you, I mean, I might want to do that when I retire. How does Gartner select those?
Definitely. So I'd love to talk with you about that. There's a really extensive process in making sure they're qualified in the IT department, and we also want to make sure we're getting people that are passionate about what they're doing and that are going to give their all to our clients. So mm-hmm. I'd love to talk about that maybe later down the road. Feel free to reach out to me when you're retiring.
Okay, sounds good.
So I'd love to move forward with this today if you're comfortable. At this point, do you feel comfortable recommending Gartner services to the rest of your company?
Price is the only thing that's standing in the way.
So what about the price is still concerning you?
It's just not in the budget right now, mm-hmm. so I'd have to build the case to increase the budget.
Definitely. And another thing you're going to see with Gartner is, I know you mentioned that a lot of employees are getting frustrated with the system, and while that's not a main concern of yours, it does cost your company a lot of money when people are leaving and you're going to have to onboard new people. So I think by figuring out that system and getting that all squared away, that's another cost that would be discounted, as well as restructuring how the budget works out. Mm-hmm. So there are a lot of ways that you're cutting down your budget and your costs with this, in addition to increasing the value of your department. So I hope that you'd be able to see how these costs would be mitigated by the benefits you're getting in those hard dollar cost savings in your budget.
Yeah. I mean, I just need to increase my budget, I think, is the thing.
Definitely. And this is how you're going to get the leverage to do it. I mean, when you go into a meeting and you're asking for more money, especially in this time period when you're cutting costs, everyone's going to shoot you down right away. But if you show them these numbers and they're as surprised as you were when I showed them to you, there's no way they won't increase that budget.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I need to do with my CEO. I need to have that conversation with him, I think.
Definitely. So I'd love for you to have access to these documents when you have that conversation with your CEO. Would you feel comfortable with a verbal contract today to sign on to Gartner Services so you can have those moving forward?
Can I take this with me and show my CEO?
I cannot actually take that with you right now because this is confidential to Gartner Services, but it's something that we'd love to provide you. And this is actually a 27-page document. Mm. So this is just one page of all the research you'll get to help you convey that need.
So how do I get that then?
You have to sign on to a Gartner subscription.
Okay.
So is that something you'd feel comfortable with moving forward today?
How does that work?
So
3 years? I don't know about the 3 years.
Definitely. Right. So this is something that you're going to see a lot of value in and a lot of benefit moving forward. You know, if you are a little bit concerned about the timeline with this, I would feel comfortable making another meeting. Mm-hmm. If you wanted to talk to the CEO and see what his thoughts are, how do you feel about that?
Yeah, let's do that.
How about tomorrow at noon? I'd love to meet with you after you get a chance to speak with him and get this all squared away.
Okay.
Sounds good. I'll see you then.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
All right. Take a breath.
Thank you.
Good job.
Thank you.
Where are you from?
Kansas State.
Okay. Having fun?
I am having fun. I'm honestly just happy to be in the semifinals. Yeah. So I'm a sophomore, so I thought that was going to be more of a hindrance.
So this is your first time doing it?
At NCSC, correct, yeah.
Okay. Okay. What have you did you do ICSC?
I didn't know.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So this is your first sales competition?
No. So I've done I'm doing 6 this semester, but this is my first like NCSC.
Okay. Uh-huh. Cool.
Well, but you're a great buyer. Thank you so much.
Of course.
Do you mind if I ask what the main objective of the meeting was?
The main objective?
Like to close meeting or to get the deal?
I don't know if we can share that
yet. Oh, that's fine.
Yeah. I'm gonna be cautious.
Okay. Yeah. No
but
problem.
You did good.
Thank you so much.
Sure thing.
Well, enjoy the rest of your day.
Yeah. Thank you. Nice meeting you.
Yeah. Great to meet you as well.
Have a good one.